notice here, you draw into it, not out of it. When you start, you make a thick line, and when you draw out, you make a thin. So if you start from here and go in, you end up with a sharp point. So all we've done here is add some heavier lines to here, add this little bit, and then a little bit darker area there. The only way you learn to do this is by doing it. Okay? You can talk about it all day until it gets down on your piece of paper. It's theory. It is. Oh, I like your. Yes. Very good. So was the solder. The solder was really good on the form. If you haven't been looking at the form, you should. There's some good stuff showing up. Not the form. Facebook. Most of it anonymous because they have no idea. We haven't drawn a single thing that's white. Not a single thing, and yet all of a sudden the white is on top of the dark because you're drawing into the white. You can lay the dog down and do a rubbing on it if you want. Coyote or fish make very good rubbing. See a dead one that's kind of dried on the bank? That makes a beautiful rubbing of its scales. You don't have to draw scales. Then you've got a pattern of fish scales from which to work. Alright. Okay? So that was three steps, four steps. Okay, we're going to do one more thing. Stop about halfway through it. Great. Let's take a piece of paper and a pencil. Trees. You can't draw trees in, you know, you can't eliminate trees from your journal because you know, if you lived in western Nebraska somewhere, you probably get by without learning how to draw trees. But around here, it's pretty tough. So, tree bark. You gotta look closely at the tree. There's three kind of trees. You got a birch, a maple, and an oak. Right. So you ask yourself a question. Is the bark rough or smooth? Is this bark, let me tell me, smooth? This one is. Lines in the bark vertical or horizontal? You say, well, all tree bark is vertical, right? It has to be. No. Look at this one. All the lines are horizontal. The lines here are all over the place. The lines here are vertical. Okay? And are the furrows deep or shallow? How the heck do you get deep or shallow? Good God. By how dark they are, okay? By how dark they are, and how uniform they are. Okay, show you. We're going to use graphite pencil again. All right. American beech. The lines are primarily go this way. And there's, if you look at this tree, there's a light side and a dark side, right? Light side and a dark side. So what does that look like? Okay. Here's some. Give it a whirl, quick. Just give it a quick. You can turn the lights on. All it is two parallel lines and some shading, you know, that goes from light to dark. And then a little bit, it's the same tree you drew with the eraser. Exactly the same tree. And see here, when you want a deep groove, you make it dark. If you want a shallow groove, not so dark. See, this area is behind it, so it's dark. This area is behind it. So this is not photorealism, it's just, but you can look at that and say, oh, that's a birch tree, okay? American birch tree. Which is it easier? Is it easier to draw from this or this? It should be easier to draw from this because the problems have been solved for you. Okay? When you draw from a photo, one problem is solved, well, two problems have been solved for you. One, the light never changes. And two, it is already blacked. Okay? And the bugs aren't biting anyone else. When you copy somebody else's drawing, a third thing has been solved for you. It's all the decisions you had to make have already been made for you. So all you're doing is concentrating on technique. So it's perfectly fine to copy other people's drawing, but you're practicing your technique. You're not copying your drawing, you're practicing your technique. And then you go up to a photo, and then you go outside and do it reality. But it's just different levels of problem solving. Now see the shadow, the shading, the shadows go up and down, but the little marks on it are horizontal. There you go. Can I show that? Okay, very quick. Very quick. Very good. Here's a nice one. Just, you know, no agony. Just. You got a handout on this one, too. But, here's a different kind of tree, bald cypress. It's parallel, but it's fluted at the base, and it has very deep root in it. And this area is just black, but we didn't want to put black, so we just made it dark. So, you're simply down here, I left this little detail out. See where it mimics the water here. A little rim around it. Vertical, long vertical. Not uniform. Okay? Not uniform at all. If you do this, you'll get better at it. You'll get better at it. The first tree I tried to draw was like, ah, jeez. Well, I'm an idiot. It's okay. As long as you're calling yourself an idiot, that's okay. The idea is to make a tree look like the species of tree that you're talking about. So we could go down here to the kids' area on the first floor, and you've got some trees there that are popsicles, right? The round, the wooden, you know. Mm-hmm. It's a generic tree. Fine. But you want to be able to depict what you're seeing. This already looks like a cypress to me, and she's already done connection. See? Cypress. It automatically says bald cypress. Simply, the other one says, that's all you want your journal to do is to depict the information that you're trying to show. Okay? Next one. Oh, right. Maple trees, old maple trees are very interesting because they, where's the texture? Well, it's just variations. Scribbles, there's some lines up and down, there's some scribbles back and forth, a little bit of dark. You know, you don't. Practice from your photos. Practice, and then you practice from outside. Start with copying somebody else's work, start with practicing, given the things you're done. Start looking at photos, and then go out and try to do the real thing. This one is a very freeform tree. It is kind of. The key to doing trees is non-uniformity. Nothing is uniform. Here's a nice one. Very quickly. One technique feeds off another technique. Okay. Let's take a break for come back at 11.